Welcome to lecture 6. This is probably one of the most important lectures because it sets the base for critical path method. And the title of this lecture is Network Representation Analysis, and this is part 1 of the lecture. What I would like to cover here is first, I think this is being lecture 6, we have covered quite a few topics so far. I'd like to summarize a few of these topics which we have covered. Get into network representations, look at types of network and a comparison between network, and then get into the analysis side. So we learn about the forward pass, the backward pass, the, you know, express the results in a Gantt chart, and then look how some of these results can be used in project planning. Now, as we go, take a look back. If you recall, we said that there is a time management standard for the Indian BIS, and you will see that we have covered quite a few of the topics which is under time planning. So we actually covered work breakdown structure, we talked about identifying activities, we talked about productivity standards, we talked about duration estimation, resource availability. So all this we talked in terms of duration estimation. We have not spent too much time on logical sequencing, but that will come as we go along the course. This is very important. We'll spend a little bit of time in the end today on it. And we then have to look at milestones and time scheduling. So this is the way the BIS standard looks at it. And if you look at the PMI, the PMBOK standard, these are the elements of time management. We have defining activities, we have sequencing activities, estimating activity resources, estimating activity duration, developing the schedule and controlling the schedule. So if we look at the PMI framework, what are the elements we have covered in detail?
Estimate activity duration.
Yes.
Define activities.
Yes.
Sequence
is, like I said, we will come back to sequence throughout the course. Sequence is important. But until we take case studies, you will not be able to get into the details of sequence. And when you get into precedence diagramming, also sequence becomes important. So it's something that will come through the course. What about estimating activity resources?
We haven't covered it.
We have kind of covered it with duration. Okay, so we are kind of coupled that both resource and duration are very much interlinked. So these are very, very closely interlinked. Okay, so and as you get into, if you're doing a course project or something on this, you will really get into the details of that. Otherwise, like we say, it's more of a practical issue rather than something which we can cover in a classroom. So you really have to do case studies on this, and we'll do some of that later. And so now we are actually on the develop schedule. Okay, so we have actually moved from these preliminary inputs to the develop schedule part, and later on we'll certainly go to the control schedule part. Now, if we look back, we looked at. Yeah. It is typically an order, but there can be cyclic too.
I mean, shouldn't the estimating activity duration preside estimating activity?
It can be cyclic. See, are you going to take, so it depends. Like we discussed last time, right? Are you duration driven, or are you driven by the time you want, or are you driven by the resource you have? If you have a lot of resources. And you want to, you know, the owner gives you a particular time he wants to finish it, that's what you do. So for example, a lot of large construction projects go to some of the larger construction companies in the country with almost no competitive bidding. The reason for that is the duration of these projects are very critical. And only these large companies have the resources they can mobilize on this projects to finish it in the time which the owner wants. Okay, so you can say that sometimes the duration is given to you, the resource you have to mobilize for the duration, you have to mobilize it. And if we go about it, I won't call it theoretically, the other way is given a set of resources, you can then find duration. And I think we discussed both these approaches last time. Almost in everything, critical duration is important. You take Chennai Metro, which is going on now. Duration is what is driving it, right? So how do you, so let us discuss, how does Chennai Metro manage, or how are they first of all managing to do this in this duration? What is their contracting strategy in terms of resources? How are they giving all this to one contractor?
No.
No. they are giving it to three big contractors or multiple big contractors. They are giving it to multiple big contractors because they can mobilize that many resources. If they gave it all to a single contractor, might be they would have difficulty in mobilizing all that much of resource for, because it's a very big job. Okay, so in Chennai Metro, I mean, you cannot take years and years and years. You have to actually finish the job, you know, and public has to use it. Okay, so there are so many projects like that. I mean, so if you take the real estate market today, the income you get out of selling the real estate, the developed real estate, is far in excess of the construction cost. Okay, so the owner will want to complete the project and make money out of the project rather than keep minimizing construction cost and dragging the project on. So you'll find in Bombay there are a lot of very high end development projects in which the major contractors in the country have been called, because those are the people who can actually mobilize the resources, whether it's formwork, whether it's concreting, whether it's earthwork equipment. They are the people who can mobilize it and finish and deliver the project in a short time. Okay, so again, just coming back to the original question you asked, the sequence is generally reasonable, but there will be iterations of this. Okay, you might actually go all the way to 6.5, develop the schedule, and then find that you're not meeting the target, and then you'll have to actually go back and estimate resources, or even change the sequence of activities. Okay, or even redefine activities. I'll decide I'm going to do not cast in situ construction, but prefabricated construction, which means the sequence itself gets, I mean, the activity definitions themselves change. So there is a iterative process, without a doubt. Okay, so we had discussed about work breakdown structures, and we discussed how we use it to identify activities. We discussed about duration estimating. We discussed about, we spent quite a bit of time on parametric estimating, but we understand there are other means of also estimating duration. We talked about bar charts and Gantt charts. We talked a bit about the history, the variations in usage, the advantages and limitations. We kind of expressed our schedule in a bar chart. We did this before we did duration estimation, but it was intuitive enough for you to follow how it happened. Now, we want to take off basically from here in this lecture. So if you take project planning tools or the time estimation tools, they are certainly, we covered bar charts, then we had critical path method, we have PERT, we have simulation, Monte Carlo simulation, and we have tools like dependency structure matrix. And we discussed how, we are going from simple to more and more complex tools, and complexity is not necessarily what is better. Complex does not mean a better tool. We need to use the right tool for the right situation. And our focus for the next few lectures is on critical path method. And people have found that critical path method is the right balance. It is a fairly sophisticated tool. You will see it is more sophisticated than the bar chart. It offers things which offers methods of calculations, mathematical base, which is good enough for project representation, but not too complex that we can represent uncertainties, probabilities, and things like that. Okay. So when we get into the critical path method, one thing to realize, actually critical path, PERT, and lot of these other techniques can be represented as a network form.